nothing if you do nothing. But if you do something, there's something new. If you inject some action, there's something new. As we await on God to have the divine increment in our lives, I know each and every one of us has something in your heart. I know there are prayer items that you are telling God, this is a new year, Lord, I'm waiting on you. I want to see you manifest yourself in my life. I know there are prayer items that you are taking before God, that God, look here, we are now in 2019, I need you to do something. And being in 2019, I've told you, there's nothing new in being in 2019 if you do nothing. If this prayer item, as you are still praying about it in 2018, and you do nothing in 2019, you'll still continue having it. So I urge all of us, for us to receive this divine increment in our lives, for God to have a divine entrance in your life, kindly do the following 6 points that we have gone through. Be spiritually alert, have a personal relationship with God. Please have faith, inject some action to that faith. And you'll see the divine increment that in your businesses, in your children's life, in all the circles of your life that you have, I know you are going to receive some divine increment. Today is Praise Sunday. And the Bible says that Paul and Silas, they praised their way out until the gates of jail they opened. They did nothing else. They praised their way out. You can praise your God out. You can praise. And do not take this for granted. Please stay on in the second service and in the third service and praise your God out. And you never know. Let this Sunday wrestle with God. Inject some little action into the faith that you have. Even if it is little, very little, like a speckle, God is seeing it. And He can magnify it. Take this chance as the first Sunday of the year and do something. I know all of us are waiting on the Lord, are waiting to receive this divine increment. Don't just sit there, my brothers and sisters. God is speaking. He's reminding us that He has no record of defeat. We have sung that, yes, Lord, you are the Most High. Sure, He is the Most High. Recognize as the supreme being above everyone else. And then we will see. The testimonies that will come your way. Even as you wait on God to receive the divine increment, thank God for the many things that He has done in your life. As human beings, we do not want to look behind. We always want to look forward. When you were in a hospital, or you were somewhere, maybe in the voting line, I take an example. You always want to come out of the line and look at the people in front of you, so that you get there. You even count how many people are waiting on the queue so that you can be served. And you count and you see they are 20. And you keep on waiting and thinking, now how long will it take so that I get there? But very few times we look behind to see the people who are behind us. Those people that are behind us, they're also willing, they're also wishing to get where you are. If you are walking, you are looking at the person who is cycling and you are telling God you need to get a bicycle. The one who is driving, maybe you are driving a bit, you are telling God, I need a Range Rover. If you are in a Range Rover, you are telling God, I need to get into an aeroplane. We do not want to look behind and see that you are driving and you've passed so many people that are walking. You do not want even to look behind and see that crippled that you've passed by, that she's not walking and you are walking. Let us teach ourselves to be grateful to the Lord. Even as we wait on divine increments, let us thank Him. And we see the way He's going to manifest Himself in our lives. I know that this thing is very powerful, and at the end of this year, we are going, all of us, to receive this divine increase that the Lord has spoken. That this year is the year of divine increment. That you have been waiting for, the plans that you have for this year, just believe that they are all going to be a success. Put God first and learn to trust in Him. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.